when he first kind of asked me, I was like, well, you know, sure, I don't really know what to talk about except for the painful kind of planning process I had to go through and how pretty much took a shift for everybody. Like, it was, you know, sending me emails, like, all these nasty things saying, like, why are you not getting this done and all that? And I was like, well, I could also talk about the fun we had over the weekend and pretty much all of us drinking from the same cup and got violently sick for 2 weeks, like, missed pretty much 2 weeks of class. Or it was like, or you could talk about the fact that you burst out and cried when they announced the winner and totally embarrassed yourself. And I was like, that's actually a really good point. And he got really excited. He's like, let's talk about it more. And I was like, okay, like, I haven't really thought about it. But, you know, like, I kind of went home and thought about it more. And I was like, you know, throughout the four, actually, like, 6 months of planning, I never really sat down and asked myself, why am I doing this? Why am I getting myself involved in this whole process of organizing a team of 40 when I'm not really, like, a public speaker? I don't really go out there and get, you know, myself in an uncomfortable situation. But I really felt like I wanted to lead the team. And a lot of it kind of started from in my first year when I joined MBA Games. And I went there and I saw the team spirit of Hewlett and how people just kind of came together. And it's this kind of this organic spirit thing that was formed. Everything went really well during the competition. The one thing that happened was that we got in a fight during our dodgeball game. We did really well up to that point. You know, our sports team, we did okay, got placed second and third. Our case team did really well. At the end of the day, we lost to the master. In the back of my mind, I was like, what is this? Like, you know, like, we're here for a reason. We're not here to fight. Why do we embarrass ourselves? So when I first found out that I got elected to be athletic director and he was going to be taking this on, I kind of told myself three things. So here's something we saw that came up from this year. So I knew I want to win spirit for sure. And throughout the whole weekend at MBA Games, I was like, I don't know how we're going to do this. Like, it wasn't clear to me how we're doing it because I was so involved in the process. I was running around, just making sure people would get up, making sure that people would actually, like George? Making sure people would get up, making sure that, you know, like, no one's going to be too hungover, making sure that the case team would actually catch the bus, although, like, we missed a couple of buses, and it's not our fault. So things like that were always going. But then the spirit part was a really interesting thing because we got to the ceremony and people were like, for sure you guys want spirit? And I was like, I don't think so. And then a week after, I actually looked through our profile and I saw tons of tweets from other schools saying like, Sheila, you guys were amazing. You actually helped out, you know, picking up garbage. You were supporting other teams. So there's one team from Victoria that had like four members. We actually were cheering them on. I think Andrea's one of the team members actually like sent congrats to Robinson for winning a case competition. So just like we really went out of our way to support other teams and show that we weren't just there just for ourselves, we were there to actually network with everybody. And the picture on the right, the bottom right, was when we actually showed up at the opening ceremony at 7, and everyone else showed up at about 8:15. And everyone's kind of like, why are you guys here instead of just getting drunk? But we were there. So I kind of started thinking about, like, how did I put together this team? Or how did we come together? And there's a team of 40 of, I say majority people didn't really know each other. So I thought about it and I was like, these are the three things that I actually like stuck to throughout my planning process. I made sure that I want to be fit. There's people that came up to me in May and saying, hey, so what do you want from me? You want to just go out and get drunk and then put me on the team? And I was like, no, that's not how it works. I don't care if I've been friends with you for 2 years, you know, I don't care if you are actually really good at networking. At this point, I want to put together the best team. And I want to make sure that whoever I'm selecting has that personality that will complement with the rest of the team that I'm selecting. So I definitely lost some friends over this whole process. There's people that actually don't talk to me. There's people that were selected to be on case comp that you know, had to leave for some other reason, and they don't talk to me anymore. And I do have to take that kind of feedback as a team lead. The second point is dealing with people that I don't actually know at all, coming up to to me and said, hey, I played basketball for Queens in undergrad, and you know, so you should read some articles about me. And I'm like, okay, you're a hotshot, good for you, but what's your personality? And they're like, well, you know, I'm really busy this Sunday, I can't come out, and you should come to your tryout. And I'm like, too bad you can't come out, I don't know how you gel with the rest of the team. That's it. So they came out, you know, some people actually came out and showed a personality, and then they got on the team, so that's great. I for sure made everybody know that I wasn't looking for people with talent and skills, and you know, you can rebound or jump or do whatever. I was looking for personalities as well. And the third point was to make sure that I always engage everybody on the team. And I think this is where I felt that I was struggling with the most, because it is a team of 40 people. I have no control over 12 of the 40 people because they were selected by Joe Fate to be on the case comp. So I knew my limitation. So the first thing I kind of sat down was like analyzing, like, what are some of my weaknesses as a team person? Because I knew that I don't know anybody in school. I don't have control over everything. I don't know how to play hockey. I'm not gonna go out there and yell at a 6-foot guy and just be like, hey, go play faster and tackle somebody, or I don't know, do something, right? So I really realized that I had to leverage my network from that perspective. So I started sitting down and saying, like, all right, so for case competition, I don't really have any relationships with them. I know they do boot camp for 3-4 hours each Friday. How am I going to actually get them involved? Part of the MBA games, I have to do some volunteer hours, I have to do this silly dance routine with all this bright green hoodie. And all these silly stuff that none of the MBAs really think is all that important, because they just want to come participate and get over with. They don't really care about the prep work. So I had to really leverage my network through GDC, so Boring and their who are on the case team. And so, you know, you guys are kind of like my influencer. How can I get your team to be involved? And although we're all the same team, you know them better. You know what will motivate them. You know that these are their schedules, and just kind of have that same mentality going. And a team like hockey, so I have Kyle Franklin, who definitely a great leader. He plays hockey. I know he's one of those leaders that can just kind of, you know, snap out of it and just be like, guys, we're not doing well, let's just get going. And I knew he was going to be positive about it too. He wasn't going to be a downer, going to be yelling at anybody or like asking anybody to leave the game. So I knew he was going to motivate everybody. And then there's this guy, James McDonnell, that is apparently really likable, and he kind of gets everything done. So I went up to James and I was like, I need someone who kind of like lead the spirit team. And James, he does take on a lot of stuff, and he does have a lot of fun. I know when I need him to jump into a certain situation, he was going to do it. So really sticking through these three points, I think what really led us to success with the NBA games. We did okay with the sports, you know, we came second in volleyball, we came first in finance in the case competition, but that wasn't really enough. And I think what got us to really win the cup and bring it home is really the spirit points. So I think really some of the key takeaways from today is that I think as we're becoming a leader, it's really important to realize your own weaknesses and like the people around you, and understand how other people's skills will complement your weakness. It's, being a leader is not really about going out there and say, I'm gonna conquer it all, I'm gonna, you know, have my hands and everything and all the tasks and actually like lead it. It's my task. It's actually about understanding that some people should take on some responsibilities because of their strength and you're not able to do it, but having that trust as well to know that they will deliver whatever you're looking for. So for James, I trusted him to just take on the spirit component of it. I knew he was going to be great at singing and like playing guitar at our opening ceremony. So just making sure that at the end of the day, it is part of being a team and it's not. Thank you.